This is the Cold War, year by year. An exploration of America's longest conflict. Chapter 2, 1946. The year following the end of the Second World War marked a critical juncture in global history, with nations grappling to rebuild and redefine themselves in the harrowing aftermath of global catastrophe. But rather than the hoped-for restoration of universal peace and unity, the year unfolded with increasing apprehension among the leaders of the Western powers, who had grown increasingly concerned about what they perceived as a dangerous expansionist agenda emanating from the Soviet Union. The first year since the end of World War II saw the inaugural meeting of the United Nations General Assembly in London, where representatives from 51 nations gathered to establish that organization's structure and address the challenges of post-war recovery. Key committees were formed, such as the International Court of Justice and, most urgently, the UN Atomic Energy Commission. In the wake of America's show of atomic power in the bombings of Hiroshima and Nagasaki, the specter of nuclear war loomed large on the world stage. The first session of the General Assembly opened on January 10, 1946, at Central Hall in London. Clement Attlee, the new Prime Minister of the United Kingdom, addressed the Assembly.
We realize, as perhaps never before, a choice is offered to mankind. Twice in my lifetime, a war has brought untold sorrow to mankind. Should there be a third world war, the long upward progress towards civilization may be halted for generations, and the work of myriads of men and women through the centuries be brought to naught. I welcome, therefore, the decision to remit the whole problem of the control of atomic energy to a commission of the United Nations Organization. In this discovery, we can see set clearly before us in tangible form the question that faces the modern world. We must, we will succeed.
In February, George F. Kennan, a U.S. diplomat, sent a pivotal telegram from Moscow that outlined Soviet ideological beliefs and expansionist aims. This communication, dubbed the Long Telegram, laid the foundation for the U.S. policy of containment, which aimed to curb the spread of communism. Kennan's insights into Soviet intentions influenced not only U.S. foreign policy, but also the broader global response to the emerging Cold War. The concerns articulated by Kennan found resonance in Winston Churchill's historic Iron Curtain speech delivered in Fulton, Missouri, in March 1946. Churchill warned of the growing influence of the Soviet Union in Eastern Europe, urging Western nations to stand united against the expansion of communist ideology.
From Stettin in the Baltic to Trieste in the Adriatic, an iron curtain has descended across the continent. Behind that line lie all the capitals of the ancient states of Central and Eastern Europe: Warsaw, Berlin, Prague, Budapest. All these famous cities and the populations around them lie in what I must call the Soviet sphere.
This speech served as a rallying cry for the formation of alliances and solidarity among Western nations to counter the perceived threat posed by the Soviet Union. While the U.S. and Soviet Russia grappled with ideological conflicts, smaller nations faced internal struggles that mirrored the broader global tensions. In Greece, a power struggle unfolded between government forces and leftist communist groups. The National Liberation Front, supported by the Greek Communist Party, sought to challenge the existing government and establish a socialist regime there. The conflict escalated into a full-scale civil war. Western suspicions of Soviet Russia's support of the National Liberation Front was not unfounded, as by now the Soviet strategy of supporting communist and leftist movements was becoming clear. Eventually, the United States and the United Kingdom intervened with military and economic assistance to pro-democracy forces. The leaders of the rebellion were captured and shut down with extreme prejudice. Simultaneously, a crisis emerged in Iran. The withdrawal of Soviet forces from that nation was delayed, violating the agreed-on dates that were established at the Tehran Conference of 1943. The reasons for the delay were multifaceted. The Soviets were concerned about the potential influence of Western powers in Iran, a country that held strategic importance. Additionally, the Soviet Union sought to maintain a friendly government as a buffer against what they saw as Western interference. International pressure, including efforts by the United States and the newly formed United Nations, finally led to the withdrawal of Soviet troops, bringing an end to the crisis. However, pro-Soviet states formed within Iranian borders, including the Kurdish Republic of Mahabad, continued sporadic and localized insurgent activities in the region following the Soviet withdrawal. The year 1946 also witnessed the continuation of the Nuremberg trials, a landmark series of military tribunals held to prosecute prominent leaders of Nazi Germany for war crimes. Defendants such as Rudolf Hess, Joachim von Ribbentrop, Hermann Göring, and Julius Streicher faced charges related to atrocities committed during the war. The trials resulted in death penalties for some, while others received prison sentences. The Nuremberg trials played a major role in establishing legal precedents for international justice and holding individuals accountable for war crimes. Collectively, the events of 1946 would set the course for global relations going forward and would influence the trajectory of international politics for decades to come. The echoes of 1946 would reverberate through the decades ahead and serve as a warning of the complexities and challenges still to come in the Cold War. Coming up in Chapter 3, 1947 would see the introduction of the Truman Doctrine as a policy of containment against the spread of communism. Secretary of State George C. Marshall would propose his European Recovery Program, commonly known as the Marshall Plan. The CIA would be established, and the Roswell UFO incident would add to the atmosphere of suspicion and secrecy during these early years of the Cold War. That and more, next time on the Cold War, year by year.